Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. In this lecture, we are going to learn how we can use the two-digit LED display with Arduino, which is based on 74HC595 shift register. This is very simple way to display two digits. In many applications, you need to display some numbers. Let's get started with this. This is the first time that we see a module is available with two-digit display with simple connectivity for Arduino. Finally, this is based on 74HC595 shift register, and two digits have been arranged and the module, something like this. When you buy it, there will be no pins attached to it. Simple, there are two surface mount devices. All the LEDs have been arranged with the bias with the resistor, so you don't have to worry about the resistor. All the pins labeled here, and as you can see, you can cascade it also if you have other digits attached to this, but for now this two will be enough because we have four digits and eight digit display already available. This two digit has its own application. In many cases you will need it to just display from between 0 to 99. About the display, if it is common cathode or common anode, because it has already been arranged, and the power supply, it works with 5 volts, and you need to connect 3 pins that is required for the 74HC595 data, clock, and latch, which changes the state of the movement of data to move from one digit to the other one. The digits are here 0.5 inch, the length of the module is 1.5 inch or 38.1 millimeters, the width is 25.8 millimeters or 1.01 inch, the depth is 0.48 inch or 12.2 millimeters. So the pins have been labeled VCC, ground, SDI, and SCLK, which is clock, and then load. This is the input. They put also an arrow and also P1. And this arrow shows you can continue the other way. For example, if this was your first one, and if you want to connect the next one, you can wire them here. The code that I'm providing will work only with two digits. In the future, I might update the code so it can work with multiple digits, but there is no need for it as we already have four-digit display, which I have separate video lecture on those. The link will be below this video. Now let me explain the wiring. This pin is connected to 5 volts of Arduino here at this point. Gray is the ground. It has been connected to this pin of Arduino. We have data, clock, and load pin. And I've arranged them accordingly. This data is the white one connected to the 7. Clock is connected to 6. And then load is connected to 5. Let me explain the code. I've taken the code from this web address. It had a lot of issues and I've cleaned it up and made it easy to be used. This is the library. You need to download the zip file. I've also fixed it. Arduino was not accepting it. I made some modifications so it can work. Once you download it as a zip file, you can go to sketch, include library, and add .zip library. I prefer this method because I know what I'm doing and where it is being saved, rather than my document. So it's saved in my own folder. Here, let's say this is a zip file, just click open and it will be done. And this is the code that will work, the code example that is with it. It might not work. I've modified this for this purpose. We are defining SDI pin, pin 7, S clock pin 6, load pin 5, digits 2. For now it works only with two digits, but in the future you might be able to add, cascade many of these. And then we are creating an instance of the this class, and we call it SR, and we pass all these four parameters here to this. Do not change this, change these numbers if you don't have those pins available, except the two. And these are still, these three and four are not available, but I've just left them from the original code. This array had some issue with digit 6 and digit 9, which was not shown properly. These are each segment of the 7-segment display. For example, for 0, you need to turn, and this is A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, and this is the last pin, or H. It goes clockwise from A to F and then G, and then it goes to DP. For 0, everything will be turned on except this pin. So that is this one. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, and then this is G. Because this is common anode, you need to send 0 to turn them on. For all other digits, inside the setup, we don't do anything. Inside the loop, in order to display a number, let's say you want to display 18, just I've written this function to make it easy. Show number and 18. It keeps it 2 seconds waiting, and then I said, let me have fun from 0 to 99. This is a for loop, and we put show number the same way as this, except this time I is getting 1, 2, 3, and every time I changes, this prints it within 100 milliseconds, it prints again 2, 3, up to 99, and then I give it 2 seconds. This time I start from 99 up to 0 and decrementing. Here it was incrementing, going from 0 to 99. This goes from 99 to 0, and printing it, and then give it 2 seconds, and it continuously doing the same thing. So for your application, you just use this and put your number between 0 to 99. Now, show number is a function that I've written here. Show number, and the number or digit that you pass will be here, and it will be called num. And this is a modulus method. You divide it by 10 to get the last digit, and we call it digit 2. And here, this is getting the digit 1 from those two, num divided by 10, and then modulus 10. Modulus mean remainder, and the remainder of this will be the first digit. And here we are number to print. This is a value, and we get 1 digit and 2 digit from the array. So digit 1 comes here, and it goes inside the digits array. This array that is holding, let's say if it was 2, it will pick this up and stores it as an array. This array will have 2 values. First value, second value, and it goes to this source, and then set all. This will print, which is taken care of by library. To display a decimal point on a digit, if you look here, this last bit is to keep this off, 1 mean off, all these ones. To turn it on, change it to 0. If I upload the code, you will see that whenever it is 2, you will see that it will display a decimal point. 2, you saw it, and then 2 again, 2 here. Every time it is 2, you see that it shows the decimal point. And here is a close-up demonstration. It shows first 18, and then we go from 0 to 99. And then we wait 2 seconds. When it reaches 99, this is 100 milliseconds in between, and when it goes down, I put 50 milliseconds, so it goes very quick, and then 2 seconds stops, and it goes back to this number. At the moment, I've activated the decimal point. This decimal point, this was 0 in the code. At the moment I've activated the decimal point, if I change this back to 1 and upload the code, you will see that it will not show the 2 with the decimal point. Repeat. Thank you for watching. This was how to use 2-digit 7-segment display with Arduino with easy code. If you have comment or question, please leave a comment below the video in this the comment section. I try to answer and reply. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.